Hi, Lorraine Youngblood with Lady Design Interiors. This video series is going to be about interior materials for all of your residential interior needs. And I'd like to start the discussion with quartz solid surface materials. Very many people have heard about quartz as a countertop material. It's very popular, very well marketed, and exceptionally easy to get a hold of. And so what quartz countertops are is a manufactured product that is made with a natural stone quartz ground into an aggregate and put with a polymer binder. And there are plenty of manufacturers out there making quartz countertops now. You'll be able to find that easy to get a hold of. What makes a quality countertop, quartz countertop material is the percentage of quartz to binder in the product itself. And each manufacturer will be different. You should be able to research that and find out. It will be in each manufacturer's specifications. Anything over 70% quartz is considered a higher quality or higher end quartz material for countertops. And over 80 or 90% is exceptional. So what that means is that quartz is an exceptionally dense, super hard rock, stone, natural stone, and it is the higher the percentage or density of quartz in the quartz countertop will create higher heat resistance, higher scratch resistance, and higher stain resistance. Now, which is one of the great things about solid surface countertops. So those are all great things and something that you can look for when you're shopping for quartz countertops if that is what you choose to do. And so then that brings us to the conversation around heat, scratch resistance, and stain resistance. All quartz countertops will be advertised as heat resistant. We must be aware that heat resistant is not heat proof, and the weak link in all quartz countertops is the polymer binder or the binder material that they use. So be aware, read warranties. They all call for you to use hot pads. And depending on the quality of the quartz countertop, it can react or change color if it is exposed to exceptionally high temperatures. So be aware of that. And then as far as the scratch resistant goes, the higher the quartz content, the more scratch resistance you will find. They have a pretty high scratch resistant. People ask me all the time, can I cut on my quartz countertops? I say absolutely if you want to sharpen your knives every day. So that's it. They're typically much stronger and harder than the fine blade of your knife, and you'll do a lot of knife sharpening if you use your quartz countertops as a cutting board. Stain resistant. The polymer binder in the quartz countertops makes it what they call impermeable. It is super stain resistant. It doesn't mean it's stain proof. There are some things that still can stain it. There are ways to get stains out of all countertops, whether they're quartz or natural stone. You'd want to see your professional about that if you happen to have a quartz countertop and want to know how to get a stain out. So, and every manufacturer has their own warranty as to what they will cover and won't cover as far as how that works. Chipping, it can occur depending on how you're using your kitchen. You want to be aware of the very contemporary flat, straight lined edges. The smaller the radius on the top edge, the more likely it is to chip in your kitchen. Sinks is a really big space where that happens as you're banging pots and stuff around on the corners and edges. So the only other thing is maintenance and cost. So quartz countertops, no maintenance, there's no sealing involved, there's no upkeep. Antibacterial dish soap should be the only thing you ever need on a quartz countertop. You do not want to be using anything with bleaches and vinegars, citric acids. It is still a pigmented material, and so you can affect the color over long term if you use those products. So be aware of that. Again, talk to your professional and see if they have other recommendations. I believe Simply Green is one of those products out there that is usable in addition to your standard antibacterial dish soap. And then cost. Depending on where you're going, the cost can range widely, but in general, quartz countertops will start slightly more expensive than a natural stone and can exponentially get more expensive quite a bit faster. But there's going to be a mid-range price point there where it won't matter whether you're going natural stone or quartz countertops. And in that mid-range, I say go with whatever material you really want, color, pattern, and the qualities that you're looking for. That's all for today on quartz countertops. And if you have more questions, please feel free to comment in the video. I will do my best to answer those questions. I have been selling and working with a custom fabrication shop that specializes in natural stone and quartz. And I've been with them for 11 years. I know a ton about it. I talk to my fabricators every day, and they have a ton of experience with what works and doesn't work as far as durability and sustainability, all that kind of stuff. If you have more questions, again, please leave a question in the comments. Happy to answer. Stay tuned. Next video will be about natural stones, which is a whole nother topic. And I hope you have an amazing, amazing day.